It took me a month to learn how to kickflip because I decided after I learned how to ollie instead of learning any of their tricks.
It took me from like start to finish 6 years to land a kickflip.
It would take me to do a kickflip 2 weeks. I fell on my ass a bunch of times, but I still did it.
I can't even do a kickflip.
Hi, Ningaseo. Welcome to another video. Today we have a crazy, crazy busy day ahead of us, but we are starting off at one of my favorite places on this godforsaken planet. Yep, Whole Foods. Also, the other day, Sarah and I watched a movie where the entire location of the film was filmed in this area.
All I care about is that I'm not still an assistant when I'm 28.
I'm 28.
Oh my God, I'm so sorry. For you, that's very sad for you.
So I made these every single morning, and this is the first morning where I made Sarah Dici her own, but we've been watching Harry Potter for the last 2 days.
You're a wizard, Harry.
That means a full movie 2 days ago, and then a full movie yesterday. So today we're gonna try our best not to fall into that trap, even though it's tempting. Start for the morning, watch a little YouTube video, and then the day ahead of us, guys, oh, it's so much. You have a busy day?
Oh,
are you okay? The kickflip. This is my favorite trick by far, but I know a lot of people out there want to go down the path to learn how to kickflip, but you might not be able to gauge how long that'll take you. Sorry, I saw an airplane like 10 feet above the water and it just freaked me out. Now, I wanted to make this video pretty much just to put out there that anyone who is not physically handicapped can do this trick 100% guaranteed, and people who are physically handicapped. I'm just saying that I've heard so many people say that they don't have the hand-eye coordination to do it, that they've known that their imbalance is off, they're not talented people naturally, and they think that they don't have a chance of accomplishing this. But you do, because I know a lot of people who really aren't talented. I wouldn't even consider myself someone who's naturally talented, but I did eventually learn how to kickflip, and for me, it took 1 year. But why would it take me 1 year? Why would it take this guy 6 months, this guy 8 months, and why would it take this guy, Mike Boyd, 5 hours?
Skateboarding is very, very hard. I set myself a goal, and that goal was to land a kickflip. Why did I choose a kickflip? Because a kickflip is the easiest move you can do on Tony Hawk's Pro Skater.
And right now I'm gonna put this out there as a challenge and as a true belief inside of my insides, okay, that anyone who has the ability to jump or do jumping jacks can learn how to kickflip within 2 weeks, and I mean anybody. 2 weeks, that seems so impossible. It's not, I promise. Now here is what it takes to be able to figure out how to do a kickflip quickly and to go in with the right mentality to accomplish this pretty crazy feat. First of all, you have to go in with the confidence of knowing that you can do it, and that is already where a lot of people fail, is go in and just know that you're another person that can do it. 100% guaranteed, you know you can do it, now you can move forward. Second is that you have to realize that the time that it takes to learn how to kickflip equates to the amount of time you actually spend on your board, popping your board, flicking your board. That amount of time spent on the board that Mike Boyd, the guy who did it in 5 hours, he spent all that time on the board. He spent 5 hours on the skateboard. Now, in a matter of a year, someone who says, oh, it took me a year, I guarantee you they didn't actually spend time with their feet on the board, popping and flicking the trick, committing to the trick for more than 10 hours, which seems so crazy. How could they not spend 10 hours doing it? It's because a lot of people will try a kickflip once or twice and then get bummed for the day and then move on and say, that was my day of trying it, but it requires you sitting there dealing with the pain, dealing with the agony of going through it, and I promise, 2 weeks. I'll be completely honest, I don't feel so good. If I push myself that hard, I usually feel pretty ill afterwards and I have to rest at least a little bit, get some lunch, go home, calm down, and then hopefully very quickly embark on the rest of the day because there's too much to do for me to have like 2 hours of downtime, so. But a lot of those tricks I never really do, and some of them I think were kind of new. So that's sort of a good parallel on what it takes sometimes to really get the trick that you want to learn. And the truth is about skating, the access of entry, what it takes to learn a few basic tricks is a lot more difficult than a lot of other activities or sports. But once you learn that, once you learn how to work really hard to obtain something like that, it's a good parallel for the rest of your life, for a lot of things that you can accomplish in the future. So I'm gonna put the camera down and I'll see you in a second.
I just took a shower, an Aizen shower, and I'm gonna take a nap because I have an excuse. My Boosty board needs a little bit of charge, and I was like, oh, 30 solid minutes to put my head down and lay down and then continue the mission? Yeah.
I'm feeling hella rejuvenated, feeling good. Heading towards the office right now, but we're gonna stop by this shop. I'm pretty sure it's an anime toy shop or just a toy shop. Can't remember, this thing is beeping out of control for some reason. But I've been working on this story, this idea. I don't know if it's gonna come out in a book form, cartoon form, whatever form I can create it in, but it's this big idea, and I just wanna go to the store to sort of get some inspiration, look around. And yeah, a lot of it's gonna come out through Progress Daily, my clothing company, so characters that I'm working on, and just all this fun stuff. I just want it to be like super feel good, super fun, and then also something that makes you think, bro. It makes you think. All right, here we go. Strange that as an old man I'm very inspired by Hello Kitty right now. I think it is. But if you watch any documentary on it, there's one on Netflix that just came out, you will feel me, boy. It is like, I don't know. That's what I'm sort of stoked on with the characters, is doing something similar to what you just saw. The characters from Kiki's Delivery Service, Totoro, and all the stuff from Sanrio, including Hello Kitty and all that stuff. I just like characters. I like creating different worlds and all that stuff. And right now, that's what I'm so stoked on outside of skateboarding, of course. I always want to skate and I always want to do that, but there's so many other things that I'm just like, genuinely stoked on trying it out. I literally just sat here and filmed the video that you guys may have already seen of the coffee shop. The whole thing was shmang right here. So I'm gonna move on. That was all I came here for. I have to clean just a little bit, but I have to hurry home because I have to get something done by 6 p.m. and it's 5 p.m. So let's keep going. Let's keep hustling, bruh. Okay, it's been an hour and I've got my video uploaded on YouTube, except for this one little thing right here. As you can see, it says, oops, our server has a temporary problem and couldn't do what you asked for. Try again in a few minutes. Oh, interesting. I totally understand what that means. Dude, I just clicked edit and look at this. What is this though? YouTube is struggling. Guys, what is YouTube what it was like a year or 2 years ago? I feel like it's so much different of a platform and I feel like I get this from everybody, but now it's like there's so many little bugs and issues and stuff throughout. Anyways, I still have an hour before it really has to go up, so this has to work in an hour. If it doesn't, I will throw my window. I just said I'll throw my window. I'll throw my computer out the window.
Sweetheart.
Yeah, give him a little inspiration, girl. Let him know how it do. Let him know how it is out there, boy.
But it's 10 p.m. Your sister just got home.
You're the sister?
Yeah, your sister.
Yeah, it's kind of a weird thing because we're actually brother and sister, which makes this very strange.
And when I woke up, I was like, today's the day.
Yeah.
I'm gonna get it. Like, there has been no Monday that it ever existed with this much productivity ever.
Are you serial right now?
Dude? I've been hustling. I've been making moves. I've been scheduling out this week to make it as packed as possible for us to get crap done before.
Because we're leaving Friday. I told them that
so
already.
Soon, yeah.
We're going to LA, baby.
Yeah.
Well, it's going to be fun.
Actually, this is the first time where it's like not LA at all.
Oh, we're going to Texas and then California. Not technically LA, yeah. But it's gonna be so fun. Dude, we're gonna vlog the entire time, but we won't have internet. But on that note, guys, tune in for another video, Monday, Wednesday, Friday.
Can I eat my food? God, you just
Sorry, dude, I'm hitting up to the food. All right, I'm gonna go before she beats my face and like she always does when you guys aren't around. See you guys soon. Love you so much. Progress Daily and keep killing.
Yeah.